Hello, hello, Wojciech Lepczynski here. Today, in this video, I will show you how you can pass variable to Lambda using CloudWatch event. Using CloudWatch event, you can pass variable with different value and run different code. Just only one Lambda function and completely different behavior, depending on what value variable you pass. What can you do with this? For example, you can pass a variable that will warm up the Lambda function from time to time and prevent cold starts. More about this in the next video. Or one Lambda function can be responsible for starting and stopping EC2 machines, depending on what variable value you pass. The Lambda function will execute start or stop for EC2 machines. Don't worry, I will record video about this soon. Interested? So, now quick intro, and after that I will show you how it works in practice. Okay, first, I create IAM role that will allow me to save logs in CloudWatch. AWS services, Lambda. AWS Lambda basic execute role with actions only for logs. Add name. AWS Lambda basic execute role. Create role. Okay, now let's go to Lambda. Create function. Add name. CloudWatch event variable. Python 3.11. Use an existing role, AWS Lambda basic execute role. Create function. Okay, I don't need this. Now, let's add some code. Variable from CloudWatch agent. Event.get. And for example, CloudWatch. So, if variable from CloudWatch event is equals options 1, then you can execute some code. I just print. You choose option 1, execute code 1. Now, let's copy this, and if variable from CloudWatch event is equals option 2, then you can also execute some code, but I just print you choose option 2, execute code 2. Maybe copy one more time. If variable from CloudWatch event is equals option 3, then you can execute some code, but I just print you choose option 3. Execute code 3. Of course, you can add more options. On that, I add else and you can execute some code. I print functions triggered manually or variable not read from CloudWatch event. And you can execute some code. Okay, that's all for now. Now, let's go to configuration. Yeah, timeout. Edit. I change for 5 minutes. Save. Now, go to triggers and choose CloudWatch event. Create a new rule. Add some name, for example, CloudWatch event variable, and some schedule expression. For example, just for test, rate 2 minutes. Save. Thanks to this, Lambda function will be run every 2 minutes. Okay, now we can go to CloudWatch event and add some variable. Edit. Select target. Target 1. And additional settings. Choose constant JSON text and add. For example, CloudWatch, and I choose option 2. Okay. Update rule. Let's go to Lambda. This is a variable passed by CloudWatch event. Depending on the value you provide, appropriate code will be executed. Test. Oops. Let's check this. Oh yeah, now I see. Let's fix this. Deploy. And test. As I expected, you can see functions triggered manually or variable not read from CloudWatch event. Execute code. Okay, let's go to CloudWatch. Logs, log groups, AWS Lambda, CloudWatch event variable, never expire. Let's change that. Actions, edit retention setting, 5 days. Okay, as you can see, the function is triggered every 2 minutes by CloudWatch event, and only the code assigned to option number 2 is running. Okay, so let's change the option and find out if the function will execute different code. Edit, select target, and now let's change from option 2 to option 3. Update rule. Now we can go to CloudWatch logs. Refresh. Yeah. Okay, as you can see, now Lambda function execute the code for option number 3. You choose option 3, execute code 3. Okay, that's all. Now I will clean up this because I don't want to run this function every 2 minutes. Okay, maybe one more time. Yep. Now it's working. So, thanks for watching. Stay updated and subscribe to the channel. If you want more, you can visit my blog, lepczynski.it. One more time, thanks for watching and see you in the next video.